मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी स्टार्ट विद न्यू टॉपिक इन बीबीसीआर, दैट इज मेथड्स ऑफ रिपोर्टराइजेशन. इन दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टू मेथड्स ऑफ रिपोर्टराइजेशन. देर आर टोटल 8 मेथड्स ऑफ रिपोर्टराइजेशन. अकॉर्डिंग टू केस we have to choose the method for reporterization, which method we select for the reporterization while using BBCR. So we have discussed about first two methods. In short, we will revise those first two methods of reporterization. Dr. Boger emphasizes in his article, that is some thought on prescribing, to first try to elicit the evident cause and course of sickness down to the latest symptom. As we all know that Dr. Boger, he gave more importance to positive factors, then he gave importance to which thing after positive factor? Yes. After positive factor, for which thing he gave importance? He gave importance to modalities, then he gave importance to concomitant symptoms, so that as he according to Dr. Boger, he gave importance to positive factor. So we have to elicit first what is the evident cause of the disease condition or present condition of the patient, as well as course of sickness, how the sickness starts, then how it progresses, and before what is the condition of the patient before disease appearance of the disease, then how the disease appear, then how get progressed, and what are the symptoms which are present at present, which symptoms are present. So we have to take history in detail from or before the appearance of the disease in the patient till the latest or till the present symptom. Then after positive factor, Dr. Boger, he gave importance to modalities, and in modalities he gave importance to modalities related to mental state also, and consideration of these mental state is also important according to him. Then after modalities, he gave importance to sensations, or we said concomitant symptoms, the sensations which are related to physical general as well as mental general. So in this way, according to Dr. Boger, he gave first importance to causation, then secondly he gave importance to modalities, in that mental state is also important. Then he gave importance to concomitant symptoms. After concomitants, he gave importance to general sensations. In general sensation, he first gave importance to pathological general symptoms. Then he gave importance to physical general symptoms. And lastly, he gave importance to mental general symptoms. In this way, in this sequence, while taking the case, we should find out the symptoms from the patient. And this repertory, we can use this repertory in different type of cases, and according to case, according to symptoms, whatever we found in case, according to that symptom, we have to choose the method, or we have to select a method which is applied for that case to find out the exact semi-minimum. And in this While using this repertory, the mental state is, as Dr. Gober, he is follower of Dr. Homi Hussain. So, as he was giving importance to mental state, but mental state, it should be used for final selection of the drug in all method. So, one by one, we discuss about methods of different methods of repertorization according to Dr. Gober. So, when in the case we get prominent positive modalities, in such situation or in such cases, while repertorization, while making the totality, while making the portrait of the disease, we use positive modalities in the first place. When we get the positive modalities in the case, then in such cases, while making the totality, we use the positive modalities in the first place. When the case which is having definite positive modality, then first we have to take the positive modalities or limiting factors. In that, we should give first importance to mental positive modalities, and then we give importance to physical positive modalities or physical limiting factors. For example, if which may be the mental causative modalities like fear, excitement, these may be the mental causative modalities, as well as for example, getting wet in rain. So these are nothing but the example of physical causative modalities. So when we are dealing with positive modalities, then at that time first we have to give importance to mental causative modalities related to mind, and then we have to give importance to the positive modalities related to physical. Then after positive modalities, we have to consider other modalities which are related to the whole person, or general modalities. In that, we first considered the aggravating factors and then ameliorating factors. In aggravating factors, we have to give first importance to mental aggravations, then physical aggravations. In the same way, while considering the ameliorating factor, we have to give importance first to mental amelioration and then physical amelioration. Then after general modalities, we have to consider or we have to take the symptoms related to physical general. Then we have to take the symptoms, concomitant symptoms, whatever present in the case. And lastly, location and sensation related to that symptom. So in this way, when in the case we find or we found the prominent positive modalities, then firstly we have to take positive modalities, in that first mental positive modalities related to mind, then positive modalities related to physical body, then other general modalities. In that also we considered first all aggravating modalities, then all ameliorating modalities. In aggravating modalities, we have to consider first mental symptom aggravations related to mind, then aggravations related to physical body. Then in ameliorations, in the same sequence or in the same order as like that of aggravation, we have to consider first ameliorations related to mind and then ameliorations related to physical body. After modalities, we have to consider the physical general symptoms, then concomitants, and lastly location and sensation related to the particular part. In this way, when we have prominent causative modalities in the case, we make the totality, or we choose this method for repertorization, and accordingly, as the sequence just we discussed, accordingly we have to write down according to their importance. When we get causative modalities, accordingly we have to write down the symptoms in proper sequence to make the totality of the case. Then the second method of repertorization, using modalities in the first place. First method is causative modalities in the first place. Now if we get the modalities, general modalities, more prominently in the case, then at that time we have to use these general modalities in the first place, and after general modalities we have to consider the other symptoms. If the case is having general as well as particular modalities, it is not only we get the general modalities, if we get the particular modalities in the case also, then in case of general as well as particular modalities, we have to consider the modalities first and repertorize using the following order of repertorization. That means first we have to consider the modalities. In while considering modalities, we have to consider first modalities related to mind, then modalities related to physical body. In modalities related to mind, first as usual sequence we have to consider modalities, sorry, aggravations related to mind, then ameliorations related to mind, then aggravations related to physical body and ameliorations related to physical body. Then after considering modalities, or after taking symptoms of modalities, we have to consider the concomitant symptoms whatever present in the case. After concomitants, we consider the physical general symptoms, and after physical general symptoms we have to consider the location and sensation. As Dr. Boger, he gave less importance to location and sensation. So the location and sensation, it usually we have to consider at the last place when we get the prominent modalities in the case. So when we have the prominent general modality, once I will revise, first we have to consider the mental modalities, then we have to consider the physical modalities. While considering mental modalities as well as physical modalities, we have to consider aggravations related to mind first, and then we have to consider the ameliorations. Then after modalities, we have to consider concomitants, then physical general symptoms, and then location and sensation. So in this way, in this order, we have to consider the symptoms and make the proper totality. While when we get the prominent general or particular modalities in the case. So this is the second method of repertorization. When we get the prominent modalities in the case, it may be general modalities or particular modalities. In such cases, we have to first consider modalities, then concomitant, then physical general, and then lastly location and sensation. When we get the causative modalities in first method of repertorization, first we have to consider the causative modalities, then general modalities, then physical general symptoms, then concomitants, and lastly location sensation. In this so there is some difference in the order while considering the or while making the totality in these two methods. Then the third method, that is using concomitants in the first place. So when in some cases we get clear concomitants, and when such clear concomitants are available, even we cannot get any modalities in that case, at that time we can successfully repertorize with the help of this repertory. Not necessary every time we have to get all the symptoms or all the things in the case. If only we get the prominent concomitant, clear concomitant in the case, and we cannot get the proper modalities, then also we can able to repertorize the case with BBCR. So in such cases, when we get the prominent concomitant in the case, in such places, first we have to consider the concomitant symptoms, then whatever modalities, it is present or absent, if the modalities we get in the case, then we consider the modalities. If we cannot get any modalities, then we cannot consider the modality part. So when we get the modalities, whatever it may be, one, two or more, then after concomitants we have to consider the modalities, then physical general symptoms, and then lastly location and sensation. So in this way, when we get the concomitant symptoms prominently in the case, first we have considered concomitant symptoms, then modalities whatever present in the case, then physical general symptoms, and lastly location and sensation of the part or organ. So this is the third method of repertorization using concomitant symptoms. Then the fourth method of repertorization is using pathological generals. So what are pathological generals? We discussed in detail about the pathological general symptoms. So in pathological general symptoms, there are changes takes place at tissue levels, and these changes are at different location, thus they show the expression of deviation in the constitution, and is very much important. Changes in the constitution in the patient are very much important while erecting the totality of the case. So these pathological changes are very much important, because most of the time due to changes in tissue level, changes takes place at tissue level at different part at the same time. So we have to get some changes in the or at the deviations in the constitution of the patient. So these are very much important to consider while making the portrait, while erecting the totality of the case. So while making the while repertorization, for repertorization we have to consider following order when we get the pathological general symptoms prominently. In such cases, when we get prominent pathological generals, we have to consider first pathological general symptoms, then physical general symptoms, then concomitants, and lastly modalities. So in this way, first pathological general symptoms, then physical general symptoms, then concomitants, and lastly modalities we have to consider when we get the prominent pathological generals in the case. So this is the fourth method of repertorization, and you have to remember all these sequence of each method of repertorization. In case when we get prominent pathological generals, when we get prominent concomitant, when we get prominent causative modalities, when we get prominent general or particular modalities, then in which order we have to consider the symptoms for repertorization. These orders in each method of repertorization are very much important, and you should have to remember all these orders for your practical purpose as well as for writing down your answer in examinations, because as you know the proper order, then only you can able to find out the proper similimum in clinic. Then the fifth method of repertorization, that is using diagnostic rubric. Many times by using diagnostic rubric, this is against the homeopathic principle, because we cannot consider the disease diagnosis, we cannot consider the disease condition, but we have to consider the person as a whole, not his part, not his organ, not his disease state. But many times when there is advanced pathology, and at that time we have to give temporary relief to the patient from his symptoms, when we get very few common symptoms from the case, in such cases, at that time we have these diagnostic rubrics. They are very much helpful to find out the most indicated group of remedies in that clinical condition. So when in such cases for palliation, to find out the palliative drug or the drug which is suitable in helping to overcome the present crisis of the patient, we have to arrange the symptoms in the following order. First, we have to consider the clinical rubric or the clinical condition, diagnostic condition rubric. Then whatever aggravations, it may be general, it may be particular, whatever aggravations we get in the case, then whatever ameliorations we get in the case, after ameliorations we have to consider the weak concomitant symptoms, and lastly we have to consider the physical general symptoms in such cases. So when we get the diagnostic, or when we have to give the, we have to find out the palliative drug for treating the patient, then in such cases first we have to consider the clinical rubric, then aggravations, whatever we get in the case, it may be physical, it may be general, it may be particular. After aggravation we considered the amelioration in the same order, maybe general, maybe particular. Then weak concomitants, if there are, we found in the case, we have to consider. And lastly, the physical general symptoms we have to consider in such cases. So this is the fifth method of repertorization, that is using diagnostic rubric. Then the sixth method of repertorization is following Robert's method. So which is Robert's method? That is using Bonigusen's therapeutic pocket book. How we repertorize? By using BTPB. While using BTPB, we have to consider each and every symptom as a complete symptom. We have to consider the location, sensation, modality, and concomitant, as well as physical general symptoms of each. In this way, each and every symptom should be complete symptom. And in this case, sensation and modalities which are first referred to the parts concerned we cannot consider the general sensations and general modalities, but firstly we have to consider the sensations and modalities related to part or that particular organ. And if such particular sensation and modalities are absent, then we have to refer it, we have to refer to in the general chapter. And if general modalities are represented well, they should be used for purpose of repertorization. So first, as the principles of Dr. Honing-Hussain, he gave importance to complete symptom. Each and every symptom while taking the case should be complete. And if we cannot get the complete symptom, then in such cases he advised to use doctrine of analogy. And by using doctrine of analogy, we have to complete the totality, complete the symptom. And if by when we have to consider the modalities, and if in a case we cannot get the prominent physical or particular sensations as well as particular modalities related to particular organ or infected organ part, in that case we have to consider the general modalities if they are present in the case. In this way we have to consider the we have to use the Roberts method, or the method which we use while working out the case by using Honing-Hussain's therapeutic pocket book. Then the seventh method of repertorization is when the case is having the fever totality. In case of fever, if the patient is suffering from fever and if the all the stages of the fever, that is chill, heat, sweat, all the stages, they are distinct, and then the following order which may be preferable. If one stage in these stages, that is chill, heat, sweat, if one stage is not available, the next stage should be used for the repertorization. While making the totality, while using this method, first we have to consider the chill stage. In that chill stage, we have to consider the type of chill. Is it partial coldness, which is partial, or shivering? Then time of the chill, then aggravations related to chill, ameliorations related to chill stage, and concomitants related to this stage. Then the second stage, that is heat stage. In this also we have to consider the type. Is it partial or general? Then the time of the heat, time of the heat stage or fever. Then aggravations at that stage, ameliorations at heat stage, concomitants at the heat stage. Then the third stage of the fever is sweat stage. In that type, is it partial or general? Then the time of the sweat, then aggravations related to this stage, then ameliorations related to this sweat stage, and lastly the concomitants related to sweat stage. In this way, in detail, we have to consider all the stages, that is chill, heat and sweat, all these three stages. Pathological type of fever, which is mentioned in the repertory, which can be used for the preference and final selection of the drug, but importance should be given to repertorial results, which is obtained by following the above order. That is, sometimes these rubrics or pathological types can be used by following fifth method, which is mentioned earlier, that is using diagnostic rubric. If in a case symptoms like congestion, palpitation, heartbeat or pulse, which are prominent during any of these three stages of the fever, then section on blood circulation should be used. In section on blood circulation, we get the symptoms related to congestion, symptoms related to palpitation, heartbeat and pulse during fever, during different stages of fever. So these symptoms we get in section blood and circulation. So when we get these symptoms prominently with the fever, then we have to use or we have to refer this section blood and circulation at that time. So this is the seventh method of repertorization. And the last eighth method of repertorization is use of concordance chapter. This concordance chapter deals with the relationship of remedies. As we all know, we discussed in detail about it in Bodingusen's therapeutic pocketbook. That is, in this chapter we found different relationship between remedy and which is used as we are using in BTPB. This section is used and it is mostly useful for second prescription as well as during further follow-ups, as well as when we have to plan, we have to make therapeutic plan, future plan for the patient. At that time also we have this section or this concordance chapter, it is very much useful. In this way, these are the eight methods of repertorization according to Dr. Boger. When we get any of, in case any type, any symptoms we get prominently, in any type of case, we can use the BBCR. And how we have to select the method, which method is useful for which case, this is all given in different methods of repertorization according to Boger while using BBCR for repertorization. So first method is using causative modalities in the first place when we get prominent causative modalities. Then second method is using modalities in the first place when we get general modalities. It may be physical or general, particular or general. Then using concomitants in the first place. Using the fourth method is using pathological generals. Then using diagnostic rubric. Then following Robert's method or following method of BTPB for repertorization. When we get the prominent fever symptoms or fever totality, then how we have to consider the symptoms, what is the order of considering the symptoms, and using concordance chapter. So in this way, these are the eight methods of repertorization which are useful to repertorize any type of case while using the Boger Bodingusen's characteristic repertory. In this way, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट मेथड्स ऑफ प्रेपर्ड राइजिंग.